Hi, we are Group 24. We're doing NICMAT for a warehouse layout. This is Sebastian, this is Jonathan, myself, Yusuf, Daniel, Joel, and DK.
First of all, this is our scoreboard presentation. Moving on, we are going to talk about the traffic flow of delivery track. In the figure, the inbound is on the left and outbound at the bottom. We are also doing some cross-jogging for special SKUs such as meat, poultry, and seafood in order to maintain the quality and standard of it. Type of storage system, first floor, we assume that it is stored frozen and chilled, and second floor, ambient. We use, as our product are perishable stocks, we use through FIFO. For carton flow rack, we assume that 25 meter cubic, and it's very accessible and different SKU level. We use pallet flow racks also, and it's 25 meter cube and different SKU each level, and it has immediate access to specific products.
Okay, we're now talking about picking operations. As shown in the diagram, there's only a single entrance for both frozen and chilled storage. So with that assumption, the selected picking technique would be wave picking, as it allows us to set intervals for put away replenishment and picking, mainly to avoid collisions between MHEs and pickers. Having that said, with intervals, it allows a rotation of shift for pickers so that they do not stay in the air conditioned for long hours. In case of high volume, we were able to switch from wave picking to zone picking, as frozen and chilled products are both being put away in categorization. Moving on to the second level, we will adopt discrete picking for ambient products in pallet form, as they are mainly for big supermarkets. Similarly, if a customer wants in carton form, we would then do a manual depalletization and move it to the carton flow rack for zone picking. So by providing a mixture of picking technique in both levels, we would be able to achieve high efficiency towards customers' orders.
We are utilizing three categories: stock keeping unit, barcoding, and palletizing. Our assumptions are your fast moving consumer goods. For import and cross docking, we will fully palletize in unique customer orders and unique SKUs respectively. This is a sample of stock keeping unit. As you can see, we have categorized it in type, code, brand, description, measurement, SKU. As we look further into SKU, we have organized them in category, item, brand, and code. For barcoding, we're using UPC, which is Universal Product Code. Our assumptions are we have already registered for UPC and we have our own specific identification. As you can look at the barcode, we have a manufacturer identification number, product code number, which is our SKU, and check digit. For palletization, our assumptions are all our goods are always palletized and going for outbound. Reasons for choice is easier to track goods, easy handling, and more efficient transportation process. As you can look in our pallet, this is our assumed measurement 1x1x1x2x2 meters.
Now we're going to talk about packaging and labeling. Damage control is a very important part in warehouse operations. Cartons might fall off or damage while they are being transported. The mixed cartons of SKUs will be consolidated into bulky pallets by stress wrapping during outbound. It may reduce the probability of cartons damaged or gone and enhance customer service level. The warehouse also provides repackaging service as part of value-added services. We repackage a large carton into a smaller carton, and we also replace the damaged carton.
I'm going to talk about material equipment, and these are the lists. First of all, under general handling, the basic trolley is needed because it's cheap and little to no training is required. Secondly, the cargo is also required in a two-story warehouse, one of which is because of its class C1. This was chosen so that the equipment can go in as well. And with the docking bay, the unloading and loading will be much more convenient. With this forklift that is chosen, it is electronic so that it will have zero to no emission. With the power pallet truck, it also can help with the efficiency and also good state at the wayside. With the strap wrapper, it helps with the safety of the goods and also to protect it. Second level will be a rich truck so as to suit the racking system and also be able to unload it from the lift. And last but not least will be the head pallet truck. It is cheap, efficient, and also requires no training.
Alright, now we're talking about the Warehouse Management Information System, or the WMS. The main function of it is to advise and administer the main purposes of a warehouse. So for that, primarily we will be using the barcoding system in the form of Universal Product Code or the UPC. The whole process will be supported by the electronic data interchange. So now moving on, we'll be talking about the barcoding process. So once all the goods has delivered to our warehouse, we will then use their purchase order as a reference to scan each unit barcode and then input the amount to be added to the current stock take in the system. After once that's done, we will then paste the specific barcode label on each of the goods that we have received. So after that, each rack will also have the accessible barcode attached to it so that once it is needed for all the separate cartons to be picked, our workers can just simply scan the specific barcode to subtract the given number away in the name of accuracy. So once we have picked all the separate cartons together, we will then consolidate all the separate cartons into pallets to be ready for delivery. Our WMS will also automatically then generate barcode label for each unit pallet to be delivered.
This is the end of the presentation. Thank you.